thou see me down in battle, bestride me. So, is a point of friendship. Oh, I would were bedtime hell and all well.
Why, thou ain't got a guess.
Is not due yet. I be loath to pay him before his day. What need I be so forward with him that calls not on me? Well, 'tis no matter. Honor pricks me on. Yea, but how if honor prick me off when I come on? How then? Can honor set to a leg? No. Or an arm? No. Or take away the grief of a wound? No. Honor hath no skill in surgery, then. No. What is honor? A word. What is that word, honor? Air. A trim reckoning. Who hath it? He that died a Wednesday. Doth he feel it? No. Doth he hear it? No. Is it insensible then? Yea, to the dead. But will it not live with the living? No. Why? Detraction will not suffer it. Therefore I'll none of it. Honor is a mere scutcheon. And so ends my catechism. Oh, pardon me, thou bleeding priest of earth, but I am meek and gentle with thee. Thou art the ruins of the noblest man that ever lived in the tide of time. Woe to the hand that shed this costly blood. Over thy wounds now do I prophesy, which like dumb mouths do bear ruby lips, who beg the voice and utterance of my tongue. A curse shall light upon the limbs of men, domestic fury and fierce civil strife shall cumber all the paths of Italy. Blood and destruction shall be so in use, and dreadful objects so familiar, that mothers shall but smile when they behold their infant quartered with the hands of war, all pity choked with custom of fell deeds, and Caesar's spirit ranging for revenge with Ate by his side. Come hot from hell, shall in these confines, with a monarch's voice, cry havoc, and let flip the dogs of war, that this foul deed shall smell above the earth, with carrion men groaning.